All right, welcome back to part three. In this part, we'll look at how to download our Vivado design to our Basis 3 board. Here was a simple project we started with. We started out by setting up a Vivado project to basically do this simple design where if we turn on the switch, the light would go off, and if we turn off the switch, the light would go on. In first step, we created a Vivado project where we created a black box or a purple box like this called MySWLED. Populated what's inside this by writing a simple Verilog code with a NOT gate logic. In order to get confidence that this Verilog code was actually going to work, we looked at the generated schematic out of this Verilog, and we confirmed that a NOT gate was indeed placed between the switch input and the LED output. In order to gain further confidence, in part two of the video, we looked at how to do a simulation using a Verilog test bench, and we did a quick simulation and figured out that indeed it was working as intended, as the waveform suggests. And now we're ready to download this into our board. So let me bring back Vivado again. So in order to do that, the first thing we'll do is called run synthesis. We want to, synthesis is basically like saying compile your program. So in your C classes or your Java classes, you might compile your software to generate the machine language. Synthesis is basically taking this hardware description language or a high-level description and basically creating the necessary machine-level objects for our FPGA. So it's basically it's saying, what does my FPGA have? And basically, what is inside the FPGA are logic block, call lookup tables, and so forth. And it's trying to map to that. So synthesis is complete. And now, if I open my synthesized design, so I can look at something called schematic of the synthesized design. And what you'll find is something a little different than what we had seen under the elaborated design. Now, look at this synthesized design. Switch, it has a buffer because the switch is an external component. So before it goes in, it has a buffer. And this is not a NOT gate anymore. It's something called a lookup table. And if I double click inside this, I see, should be able to see the properties of this view. Well, I guess I can't look up what's inside the lookup table here. But this is called a lookup table. Basically, this is a two row truth table between IO and out. And then there's the output buffer and the LED. So this is the synthesized design. Now, before we can get this to download onto the board, one of the things we need to consider is where is the switch connected on the FPGA pin and where is the LED connected on the switch FPGA pin. So let's take a quick look at that. So let me set up my FPGA board real quick and we'll take a look at the different pins. Okay, so here's my Basis 3 board. This is the FPGA right here. Okay, underneath this FPGA are its pins. So inside on this FPGA chip, the different pins are not visible on the side, but they're underneath right here. So one of these pins is connected to the switch, so, and one of these pins is connected to an LED. So let's use this particular switch. Okay, this switch, we'll use switch 0, and maybe we'll use LED 15. Okay, so this LED. So we'll connect between this switch and this LED. Or we could connect between this switch and any other LED. How that is done is basically this switch right here is directly connected to this, has a lot of pins. The pins are labeled just like how the Excel rows and columns are labeled. You know how if you look at Excel, you have the columns labeled A, B, C, D, E, and then the rows are called 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, these pins that are here in the back side of this particular FPGA chip are labeled based on columns and rows. So this particular switch, if I use switch 0, is labeled V17. So we're going to use switch 0. Okay, so we've decided we'll use this particular switch. So I want to use switch 0. It is on V17. Okay, so it's on V17. I want to use LED 15. Switch 0 is on V17, and I see that my LED 15 is right here. And the one this lettering on the parentheses basically tells me which particular pin underneath this is connected to that. So it's basically connected through some wires in this board, and it's connected to pin L1. So L1 is the pin for LED number 15. And Switch 0 is connected to V17, right? So we'll set that up on the Xilinx Vivado software, and that's what we'll do next. All right, so now on the simulated view, when I say open synthesized design, we looked at the schematic before. So when it did that, it also brought up this particular view. This is the underneath view of what's inside that chip. Remember I told you that just like Excel, there's A, B, C, D, and 1, 2, 3, 4. The switch was on V17, so V17, somewhere around here, right? UV17, right? So it says somewhere around here in this block is where the switch is. So let's go here. The first thing we need to do is change this LVCMOS to 33. So it's meaning all these I/O pins are going to use 3.3 volts, right? LVCMOS 3.3, first thing. And then package pin, the switch input is connected to a package pin called V17. UV16, V17, right? Now the LED is connected to L1, or you can type L1 directly here as well, or select this. All right, so we have V17 for switch, L1 for 35. Now what we're doing is basically telling this Xilinx synthesis engine what to do to the switch input and the LED output. We're basically saying make a connection to the FPGA at these two particular locations. So let's save this, and it'll ask us to save up something called a constraint file. So we're basically constraining it. So let's give it a switch LED constraint. Local to the project, say okay. And what that basically created is, once if I go here on the sources, I should see now the switch LED constraint XDC file. Later on, as we get experience, we'll directly type these. So two things happened. The first thing we did was say that both the LED and the switch were on the 3.3 volt IO standard. Set property basically means set the property of that particular pin, okay, particular switch to work on 3.3 volts. And then package pin V17 for switch, package pin L1 for LED. We'll write these constraints later on. Almost all the I/O that we'll use on the BASIS 3 board are of I/O standard LVCMOS 33. So anytime we use a design, we'll have to add these constraints if we actually want to download to the board. When these constraints are done, let's save them. And then once it's done, it says synthesis out of date, constraints were modified. So let's reload. Okay, so it's going to initialize everything. And then now let's ask it to run the synthesis again. So synthesis is now running right here. You can see this circle spinning. It might, depending on the design, synthesis, these steps could take, and depending on the speed of your computer, whether your files are stored on a network drive or a local drive, the speed of your hard drive, this process could take a long time or a short time, depending on the size of your design and the different physical parameters of your computer. So we'll let it synthesize. So it's synthesizing right now. This should be fairly quick. It shouldn't take that long because it's a fairly small design. Now synthesis basically again is taking that NOT gate, putting it in the on the lookup table. Next thing we're going to ask you to do is run an implementation. Run an implementation basically means find a way to make a connection to the design and to the output pin and the input pin. Okay, so it's going to do initializing the design. It's going to do something called place and route. It's going to go through those steps. And again, depending on the complexity of the design, this step might take up to a few minutes. In our case, the design is fairly simple, so it should take only about 30 seconds or so. So it's running an optimization of the design right now. And we will let it complete. It's doing the route design now. Routing design is connecting internal wires. And soon, right after this step, we should be done with our implementation. All right. Implementation is now complete. Okay. So the next step is called generate bitstream right here. So bitstream is what gets downloaded onto our chip. So it's gonna write the bitstream. And this should be fairly quick, actually. So it's in the process of creating the bitstream right now. All right, looks like the bitstream generation is now complete. So the next step is to download this to the board. So let me do this a little bit so you can actually see it better. So I'm going to download this to the board, and to do that, directly under programming zip, we clicked on generate bitstream before. So let's do open hardware manager. So it's going to connect to our board. So this says no target is open right now. So let me also bring up the actual camera setup. So I'm going to turn on the power. So power is turned on, and I'm going to say open target. Auto connect. So let's see, it's scanning for what device is connected right now. Looks like it found a Xilinx hardware server. We'll see. All right, it did find something. So let's see what it is that it found. Connecting, it's connecting to that server. Okay. All right, it found the Xilinx, this particular board. Okay, it found this particular board. So we'll click on this and say right click program device, or you can just from the top just say program device. My swled.bit file was just generated, so we'll say program, and it's programming. All right, and now you saw that LED light come on right here. LED light came on pretty quickly. So right now the switch is down, the LED light is on. If I turn it up, the light goes off. Up, off, down, on. Up, down. So we basically created a very simple design. And if I wanted to move this LED from here to a different pin, so let's see if I wanted to use LD6 instead of LD15, all we have to do is go back to our constraint file. So let me close out of this hardware manager and go back to my constraint file. And on the constraint file, all I would have to do is, instead of setting up L1, I would have to say, let's say if I wanted LD6, I would call it V14 right here. V14, let's say save. And I would have to do run synthesis, run implementation, and then generate bitstream. If I actually just hit generate bitstream right now, it'll run through all the processes necessary, and let's let it finish the synthesis. We'll come back and see if I can move this to basically LD6. All right, so the bitstream writing is complete. Let's open target again, auto connect. As you can see, LD6 is currently off. I will open the target and reprogram this device with the new design. And voila, so switch is off, LD6 is still off. LD7 is on. So looks like I made a quick mistake when I looked at it. LD7 is actually V14. LD6 is U14, so you got to be careful here. In the constraint file, we did write V14, which happens to be connected to LD7. So now if I let's see here, run this live. My video, oops, I don't want to record it. Having problems with my video, so let me quickly take it. All right, so I have my webcam working fine now. So when I do up, the LD7 goes down. When I go down, LD7 goes up. Again, reminder that I actually meant to write V14. I read the U14 as V14. So instead of LD6, now my LD7 is actually on. So all we had to do was change the constraint file to move the LED position. Okay, so that completes this particular video.